project's gonna be the most rockin' bus, homie. All LA, it's gonna represent. It's gonna be a street landmark for LA.
This is the bus. We are converting this school bus into one efficient, incredible filmmaking facility.
They got together and created LAFCO, LA Filmmakers Co-op, and their whole basis is it's not just to serve themselves.
All of us, or many of us, do not have the guts to do projects like this. Because it's original, because it's a great, you know, target to help people who want to make films, and it's an adventure, right? So it's like exciting, it's risky, it has everything.
Bus creates mobility. You're able to like get out and reach people. You're able to make it a part of everyone's community.
I think the bus project is visionary.
And then you just rammed right into my nipple. And you're like, ow!
The material itself is small, so it's close to you. You're able to like pick it up like a pencil and express yourself.
We may make films ourselves, but we're really looking for people who are creative and have the desire to make a film, but maybe don't have the equipment or the inspiration. So we use all of our own equipment, cameras, editing equipment, screening
equipment.
It's all on
the bus.
And a person makes the film generally at no expense to themselves.
But just real quick, before we leave you alone, tell us, what are you shooting?
I'm shooting a piece that's dedicated to my ex-boyfriend. And I know that if he ever saw me laying naked in the film or in the LAFCO bus, that he would be totally irately mad. But he has to understand that this is all a part of me.
People think that they don't have enough creativity in themselves to write a poem or write a book or write a song. And by creating art about people, it brings them into it and gives them free license to go out and do their own thing.
Perfect. We don't need to abide by any kind of rule. We make our own thing. As long as it's truthful, meaningful, and has some kind of a conflict, the thing is going to be good.
You don't understand. It's standing the question for why. I want this movie to be alive. It's a collage. It's a moving collage. It's a collage of what's behind the background noises. It's a collage of people who walk into the camera and start to talk or dance or whatever. It's a collage.
Teenage drama. Tonight on Fox. Bring me the head of Rupert Murdoch in a cardboard box!
I said that the bus, the whole idea of the bus, is on the cutting edge.
We're going to Black Rock City and Burning Man, that's where we're going, and we're going to conquer the world.
What's going on tonight? It's a big night.
We're having our first screening with the two projects we did in Point Arena, one with Justin, one with Cybrick. And we're in a local theater, community theater, and they've got the equipment, and we've got the materials, and we've got some people assembled here who all come to see the show.
Is this your premiere?
This is the premiere. Here's the tape.
I've just been waiting for the day the LAFCO bus came into my life. It's so beautiful. I'm so lucky. And I'm going to stalk you guys. I'm going to chase you down and make films like you've never seen before.
I went and looked around for people that looked like they were out of sorts, and I found these three gentlemen, one with long orange fingernails and two other adorable boys, and I thought, that's them. And I said, hey, are you guys with the bus? And they said, yes. And I said, all right, welcome to Point Arena, and the rest is history, and here we are. Here we are. So I crawled on the bus, and they showed me their work, and I said, you've got to meet Cyborg, first of all. First and foremost, you've got to meet Cyborg.
On Tuesday, when the crazy day happened, and like everybody was at my home, everybody come and we watch TV. It was just a crazy day, but then I decided to make a video about New York interviewing Point Arena people. And then I edit, they have three editing stations on the bus, so I start editing, and that's what we're gonna see tonight.
King Laden behind Han, whatever crazy groupie that dude is, and his family, whatnot. We trained him from back in America, whatnot. With G.I. Joe's, as well as James Bondism, and gave him $40 million too, whatnot. And get so cold, opium out of the country. He'd feel the country speed by the way he's around where he's at.
I just gave blood. I mean, I felt like there was
there needed to be something that we can do, and it's the most tangible thing that I could think of.
LAFCO is actively subverting corporate media with biting controversial quality films. We are shaking up the mix by getting voices to the voiceless.
That's funny.
The last pro.
Out in the great state of California, talking about a state of mind. Somewhere north of Frisco Bay, where the redwoods meet the wine. There's a people with a purpose so divine. They call